Hello friends, today we are going to see the Matravid DSO Digital Storage Oscilloscope. Its model number is DSO5070E. It's a 70 MHz DSO with a speed of 1 giga samples per second. We have connected an auxiliary supply. Now by turning it on, here comes the branding name Matravid DSO5000E series. Now first of all we will check the input ports. This one is the channel 1 input. Here we will give channel 1 input. This is for channel 2. As it is a dual channel, we can give 2 channel at a time. And the third port is a external triggering. Means if we want to trigger some signal of external, we can give that signal here also. And the last one is the calibration port, by which we can check the calibration of the DSO. Okay, now I'm just explaining the functions of this. Now this is a multi-purpose button. It's rotating also and a click also, like this. And if someone want to select this option, then just click it. Okay, and the first one is the measure function. From here we can get the parameters like amplitude, frequency, period, fall time, rise time, width, etc. The second one is the acquire, means it's a catching speed of the signal. It's in sampling mode. You can also set to real time sampling, equal time sampling, and a fast acquisition mode. The third one is the storage mode. In this, we can save the image file as well as the setup file in its DSO memory also. Also, there is a provision to give the pen drive input where we can save image, setup file, etc. Now, the fourth one is the run and stop. Means if we want to run the input signal which we have given and also want to pause it, we can also pause it the signal. The next one is the cursor mode. Here we will get cursor or like to measure the voltage and the frequency of a given signal. The next one is display function. In display we will get the format like our XY mode and YT mode. Also we get the brightness of DSO here. Then the next one is utility. Here we get the self calibration option, self adjustment, like and the next one is the recorder to record the waveform and the language also. In next option you can also reset the setting. If you have done something wrong, you can just reset the whole DSO settings by its default. And the last one is the auto function. It's a very nice function in DSO. Means if you can't adjust the waveform by using scale in horizontal and vertical, you can just auto adjust it. It will automatically adjust according to the waveform. Now the additional function is the MATSO function. Here the addition, subtraction, division and multiplication of two wave will be occurred. 2 wave means channel 1 input and channel 2 input, and we can get the result in red waveform. Now it's channel 1 input and channel 2 selection switch of means coupling, bandwidth, volt per division, and here is the probe. Probe is 1x, 10x, 100x and 1000x. Whichever probe we are using, you can just set it by here. And the additional function is invert also. Means if you are getting a signal from positive side, you can also invert it. The next function is the horizontal function. Like if we want to see the frequency in different screen, you can also see it from here. The next one is the set to zero. If your signals become up in positive and exist in positive or exist in negative, you can set it to zero signal. The next one is the triggering. Like I have told earlier, external triggering. It's a triggering menu. Which type of triggering you are using? It's a edge, pulse, and with the source of channel 1, channel 2, slope like a rise, fall, both in which mode, auto, manual, single, and like coupling, DC or AC. And here is the force triggering also. You can also force the input trigger signal to get the stable waveform. Also, there is a help menu. If we click the help, and then after click any of the command button like measure, so we can get the description that how you can use the measure function, which type of measurements. Then acquire, so here we get the acquire description, so you get the help using the help button. Okay, and these are the functions key. The display which we are seeing this can access using this function key. Also, there is a print screen button from which we can get the whole screen in image format to our DSO memory also, and also to the pen drive. So these are the functions of DSO. Now I am giving the input signal to it. I have one function generator of Scientech 40613 MHz function generator. I am just giving it input to this channel 1. And just by clicking it auto, my whole DSO will set according to its waveform. First of all, we have to get out from the help and then auto. See. Also, we will close the cursor command. And yeah, here is the word. Input sine wave signal. We have set our sine wave signal to about 1.14 kilohertz. It's a sine wave signal, and we are getting it a sine wave. Now, by using measure function, I'm getting the amplitude 10.6 volt, nearly about. By changing it function, I am setting it to time and a frequency. So yeah, we can get the calculated frequency, which is 1.14 kilohertz, the same frequency which we have given to the input. With respect to that, we can also get the result of period, rise time, fall time, width. Also, you can set the volt in volt. We can use amplitude. Same way in volt, preset. Like using measure command, we can see all the parameters of the input signal. Now, I am just storing it using storage function. So I am storing it using as a my wave, means as an image. Source is my channel 1, memory is 1, and the next button is save. First of all, we will see using this disk is DSO. I'm saving it. Yeah, my signal has saved. Now I'm taking out the signal. It's zero. Now I want to load which we have saved. So it's a load function. Reference A. Load. So you can see the signal which we have saved has come to DSO as a reference A. Okay. Now I'm giving it back our input signal. So it's our storage command. Just setting it to auto. Now here you can see our image. If our waveform is moving like this, if you want to pause the waveform, we can just run and stop command to stop the waveform. And after stop, you can also taking out the command and use a signal to amplify, to measure, like I was stopped, then I can use cursor command to measure its voltage like this. Now I'm keeping it to top view. It's top and then bottom view. Yeah, you can see the delta V, which is 4.44 volt. It's our voltage. You can also see the time, means frequency also. I'm just setting at the starting of the wave. This. And it's ending of the wave till this. By this we can get the frequency. It's 2.083 kilohertz, the exactly which we have given. Okay, so it's a function of cursor. Now I'm running it, giving again the input. Closing the cursor function. Setting it level. And now our display function. You can set the display to XY mode using this. This mode, in this mode we can see the BH curve, ellipse wave, eye pattern, etc. Now going down, it's a match function. In this, it's a match function with the addition of source 1 and source 2 occurs. Here we have taken addition function. You can also set it minus, multiplication and division also. We are taking addition. We have right now given only one signal, that's why it's giving the same. I'm just taking another signal from its calibrated input. So by turning on the match function, you can see it's adding a channel 1 signal and channel 2 signal. Also there is a FFT function, fast Fourier transform. You can also see the fast Fourier of two waves. Here is the voltage and frequency of match function. Turning it off and turning channel 2 off. Here is the position knob where you can set the waveform, wave position in vertical direction, and it is known in horizontal direction. This knob is for level of triggering. You can see a small cursor line is going up and down. It's a level of triggering. If you are going above the waveform line, it will become unstable. So you have to set it according to the waveform. If you are not precise at setting the level, you can just use the auto function. And this is the set to zero function, which I will tell you. If your waveform is say about in positive direction and you want to set to zero, just click it, it becomes in the center of the screen like this. Okay, and here is the triggering menu by which you can give the external triggering to trigger our unknown signal, like we are giving from the arbitrary function data and etc. Now we are going to see the print sprint function and our storage function to our external drive. I have taken one pen drive, just insert it to the USB port, and you can see that the USB device successfully installed with SKIM, and also the logo above the screen is SKIM. You just need to click the print screen button in the image which you are recently showing on DSO, save as an image file in your pen drive. Yeah, you have saved your image file. Also, you can use the storage command, type as setup and bitmap or wav, and just saving it as a wav, selecting the disk in my USB and saving it. Yeah, it's saved. And also saving the setup file. Setup file means the voltage and frequency, means time per division and volt per division which you have set, is saved as a setup file. Now the next one is the bitmap, the same function which we have used in the print screen. Let's save that also. So like this, you can save it to your pen drive also. Now let's see our stored file. Yeah, you can see the same image which we are viewing is stored as an image. Also our setup file which we have stored. Now we will see the one function which is recorder, comes in utility command. By pressing the utility command, there is a recorder for function. By just clicking it, it comes in the F3. Source is our channel 1. Operation is to record, pre-play, stop and return, and save as a memory 1. I am just recording it. The recording is started. I am just changing my input signal frequency. Amplitude also. Changing the frequency range also. Now by stopping it, yeah. So it's that saved in our pen drive. Now I am loading it. Load and pre-play. So you can see which we have changed. It's recorded in our pen drive. Now we are going to see the main additional feature, or you can say advanced feature of this DSO. It has also virtual connectivity with our PC. Its software is DSO Monitor Controller version 2.0. I'm just opening it. Selecting our DSO 5000E series. It's connecting. Now using this software, if you are far away from your DSO and is connected to your PC, you can also set, give command and take the measurement of your project through your PC also. It has all functions like learn, stop, ऑटो सेट टू जीरो, चैनल वन, चैनल टू, मैट्स, फोर्स ट्रिगरिंग, सिंगल ट्रिगरिंग टू सेट द वोल्ट पर डिवीजन, टाइम पर डिवीजन, ऑल्सो यू कैन सेट सी द पैरामीटर्स हियर, स्टोरेज फंक्शन, करंट स्टेटस ऑफ डीएसओ, ऑल. Now I'm just giving it command from here. See, I'm changing it here. You can also see the result in both in DSO as well as PC also. I'm just stopping it. See, I have clicked the stop button from PC and the DSO stops here. Now playing it run, the DSO start running. Also setting it auto. Water function start. See the result. Now we can also set the cursor functions from here. The same functions which we are doing using this panel, all these functions comes in software from which you can set give command and control your DSO from your PC also. It's our virtual DSO. You can just connect your DSO with the PC using a single USB cable. Here you will see the accessories of the DSO 50708. It comes with a 2 DSO probe with a 1x and 10x facility. You can just slide it. Right now it's in 10x. You can just side slide up to it becomes a 1x probe. We have one software CD for connecting to PC, for one USB cable, one auxiliary cable, and a bag for DSO probe. Okay. Next.